Hello everyone, and welcome to our Thursday weekly video devotions. I want you to imagine a scene with me. I want you to imagine a little preschooler getting out of the car on the first day of school with his backpack and his lunchbox, and he takes his mom's hand, and with a little bit of fear in his eyes, he looks up to her and says, "Mom, is everything going to be okay?" And then his mom stoops down and wraps him in a hug and says, "Yes, honey, everything's going to be okay. Everything's going to be all right." I don't think our desire to hear those words ever goes away. Whenever there's something scary or whenever something bad happens, we all long to just be wrapped in a hug and be told with certainty that everything's going to be okay. Everything's going to be all right. But you know, sometimes even if we're told that, it's hard to believe because we know that we don't know the future. What if it doesn't turn out okay? What if it doesn't turn out all right? Let's go to God and ask him that question. God, are we okay? Is everything going to be all right? Here's God's answer. What shall we say in response to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also along with him graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who then is the one who condemns? No one. Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us. God, is everything going to be okay? God says, yes, it's okay. I am for you. How can you be sure that God is for you? Well, look at what he's already given you. It says he did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all. God is for you. There is no doubt about that. You're okay. What about your sin? Well, God says, everything's okay. I don't condemn you. I'm the one who justifies you. I have declared you not guilty. If I have declared you innocent, who else is going to condemn you? Jesus certainly isn't. He is the one who went and died for you. More than that, he was raised to life and is at my hand interceding for you, telling me about you and making sure that you are the recipient of my love and my grace. It's okay. You're okay. And everything's going to be all right. God goes on to say this: Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. But God, what if bad things happen in the future? God says, well, everything's going to be all right. Yeah, some bad things will come. That's part of life. But you know what? You're more than conquerors because you have a wonderful ending. Good will triumph. It will turn out all right because I'm going to take you to be with me in life eternal. And you know what? Whatever comes, it cannot separate you from my love. Neither height, nor depth, nor angels, nor demons, nor anything else in all creation. That includes whatever you're dealing with, whether it's sickness or anxiety or depression or a disease or a lack of money or fear. Nothing can separate you from my love. It's going to be all right. God, is everything okay? Is it going to be all right? God wraps you in a hug and says, you're okay. It's all going to be all right.